Okay, members, today I'm going to see my examples about a locus. This one is telling us that finding the locus of a point which moves such that the ratio, of course we know what the ratio is, of its distance from point M to its distance from point N is 3 to 2. Now, that locus, its distance from M to N, this is the ratio in which they are giving us. So, if we say let Px be that point that is going to describe the locus. This horizon drawing is anywhere on the Cartesian that is going to describe the locus. So I'm telling us that the ratio of its distance from a point M, so M, means that distance is going to be Pm. Now the ratio to its distance from N, which is going to be Pn. But these are distances, is the ratio of these ones is 3 to 2. So that's the ratio we are giving us. All we do is, we know how to interpret ratio. This is the same as Pn over Pn equaling to 3 over 2. All we do is to cross multiply this times this. I have 3 So from here, 3Pn is going to be now 2Pn. So we substitute now. You know what P is? P is x. So now this will be now 3. Now a square root, the distance between these two points. So I will get x minus minus, which will give me x now plus 1. This is the formula for the distance between the points. Then plus the y now minus 1 squared equaling to 2, then square root of Pn. Pn, my Pn now is x minus 0 squared then plus y minus 1 squared. So from there, members, you see that to remove this square root, we are going to square both sides. So we square both sides, squaring both sides. Here we are having now a 9. When I square this, the square root will go away. Then we expand this. We have 2. Now you square the side, you square this, you get also 4. In 2, this is x squared plus, open in brackets now. Here we shall be having plus 9y squared minus 18y plus 9 equaling 2. Open here. Plus 4. Now we take everything this side. When I bring this this side, I'll be having 5x squared plus this 4y squared minus this, I'll be having 5y squared. Then inside I have no x, so this is 18x. Then when I bring this, it's like this, when I bring it this side, it will give us now 0. So 9 plus 9, that's 18. When I bring this side, I'll be adding now plus 14 equaling to 0. So that you can easily compare it to the general, which is by dividing through by this 5y squared plus 18 over 5x, then plus 4 over 5 equaling 0. So then members, you start the locus, the one that's trying this locus, and the locus is a circle. We can go to determine its center. So that its center is going to be, you multiply this, the quotient of x to negative half, we have negative 9 over 5. So that we don't have y, so it's 0. And you can easily get the radius from there. So members, that's how we get. How that's how we find the locus that. Now number 2, a point x will decide that the sum of the squares of its distance from points A and B is. Now we are talking about the sum of squares. First of all, they are in the point A. So the sum of the squares of PA. So the sum of the squares of its distance. So they are squaring the distance. So PA squared. Then they are talking about the sum of the squares also that point is going to be PB, but they are coming around the sum of the square. It means that these distances are squared. The sum of the squares of these distances are, is 4. So what we do now is to get PA, to get also PB. So from here I see that my PA is going to be now the square root of PA. I'm going to be having x minus 1 squared plus y minus 1 squared. But remember, the whole of this one is squared. Is squared, then plus PB. I'm going to be having now square root of PB. I have x minus minus, which will be now x plus 3. The whole squared, then plus y minus 2, the whole squared, then remember this one is also squared, the sum is a 4. So as soon as I square this, so now when I expand this, I have x squared minus 2x. Expanding this and expanding this, then plus, when we expand this, we have, remember this square will cancel with this, and this one will cancel with this. So this is x squared plus 6x equaling 4. So there we go, like down, this and this, it's going to give me 2x squared plus y squared, give me y squared. Then negative 2x plus 6x, I'll be having plus 4x. Then negative 2y minus 4y, give me negative 6y. Then 1 plus 1, that's 2, plus 9, 11. 11 is that this 4 and this 4, because that's why I have this side plus 11 equaling to a 0. So dividing by 2, we have x squared. Zero. So, if you compare the general equation of the sample, 2ax, 2by plus equaling 0, you see if I compare the coefficients, negative 2a is equaling to 2, negative 2b is equaling to 3, negative, then my c is 11 over 2. Start from here, my a is negative 1, my b is 3 over 2. So our center is negative 1, 3 over 2. Then the radius of this circle will be square root of a squared, which is negative 1 squared, plus 3 over 2 squared, then minus 11 over 2. So you get the radius here. If they send this frame, you display this circle, that the locus in the circle will center this and radius this units. So that's how we describe it. They ask us to describe, but they ask us just to find. So the equation of the circle, the locus is this, and here the locus is also circle. So I wish you the best.